smell something.
All right, what is good, y'all? What is good, y'all? It is yours truly, Rick the Prince, and you are watching Surface Town. You already know what to do. Go ahead and hit that thumbs up button. Social media, you know, do your thing. Your boy's on TikTok, okay? Your boy is on TikTok. I'm about to do a video talking about my TikTok experience. I've been on TikTok for like a month now. Very fresh, very just popped my cherry, you know. Still learning. But TikTok has been pretty fun. So if you want to follow me on TikTok, go ahead and do that. It is Surface Town on TikTok, all that good stuff. But we are here to talk about the beautiful, the talented, the black queen magic of Kelly Rowland. She just dropped her latest EP entitled K. Yes, K, simply. And it's how many tracks? I think it's six tracks. Let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six track EP. Kelly Rowland just turned, she just celebrated her 40th birthday. And looking at her, she is the definition of black don't crack, because her body, even after the babies, even after the stress, all that, she's still looking beautiful. Vocals still sound great. I'm very excited that Kelly Rowland is back. It's been a while since she's dropped a project, and I'm gonna make a video about how I felt about Kelly Rowland in her trajectory, because there were a lot of points, especially around 2011, 2012, 2013, where Kelly Rowland was really, really hitting y'all. Like, she was doing features, she was popping up in music videos at random. Like, she was just really giving you great quality. She was really pushing her solo career, probably perhaps to its peak, the farthest it had ever gone, with records like Ice, with records like Talk a Good Game. That album was pretty good. Of course, Motivation. Like, she was just really creating her own lane, and I felt like after that she kind of just stopped. Of course, you know, she started a family and all that good stuff. You know, I mean, what can you expect? But as far as her career goes, it's been a minute. It's been a minute since she released some music. So we're going to start off with Flowers. Flowers, I believe, is the first track. Flowers, she is credited, like, she's like the only writer on this EP. And that's another thing, like, aside from, like, Crazy and maybe like another record, she was like the only writer credited on these songs, which is pretty dope. Flowers, I love the harmonies, I loved her lower register. Black Magic, like I was talking about before, it did remind me of something that Beyonce did on Black is King. I actually wouldn't have mind having her on this song. I mean, I would have think she would have complimented Kelly very well, but I'm glad that Kelly did this EP all by herself. Hitman again, Kelly was the only writer on this song, and I believe she released this as a single sometime in last year. I love the bass, I love the horn. She played a lot with horns and instrumentation on this project, and I really respect that. Crazy was kind of like the first song released to roll out this EP. I don't even know if everyone knew that she was going to release an EP, but this was like the first record to pop that off, produced by Ricky Reed. Great production. It reminds me of something from the 70s, something that has you skating, just something that has you good dance vibes. A similar record is Motive that Ariana Grande just released featuring Doja Cat. You know, that same throwback, you know, kind of groovy record. I really like that. I really like the aesthetic that she was given. I also wanted to point out the hook. The hook on Crazy, she was probably giving the strongest vocal delivery that she gave on this hook right here on Crazy. I just want to point that out. All right, and to close it, we had Speed of Love and Better. Now, Speed of Love, I like this record because it had great background vocals, and it also was playing around with the acoustics. I really like the stripped down and simplicity of that record. And Better was a good closer because it started off as a piano and then it kind of went to like this Caribbean. I was just like, okay, what are we doing here? She was really giving me some versatility to close out this track, and I really appreciated that. So overall, K is definitely an update on Kelly Rowland's life. You know, she's in love, she has a family, she's acting, you know, she's doing all these other things. She's a grown woman, you know what I mean? She has a lot of responsibilities, and she's showcasing that through her music. I love that she talks about, of course, Black love, and being Black and loving your Blackness is something that, you know, Kelly has always stood for, especially in pop music. She's been a representation of a Black woman, and she's never tried to stray away from that. And that's one thing I've always respected about Kelly. Of course, with this EP, I would have liked some more vocal delivery. I feel like Kelly Rowland was playing it very, very safe with her vocal deliveries. I mean, she did surprise me on Crazy. She did surprise me on Better. But I know Kelly is a very, very strong vocalist, and I wanted her to showcase that a lot more on this EP. And I definitely believe that for such a long break, this should have been an album. We should have reworked this and made this an album. Six tracks. If you had six tracks, you could have made it to 10. You know what I mean? Like, this should have been an album. I'm just glad she's back making music, but I definitely believe that vocally, she played it safe. I wanted more background vocals. I wanted just more structure, more layering with her singing, and it just seemed very simplistic. I don't know if she did that intentionally, but I was wanting more. She left me wanting more with each song. Listen to the EP, let me know what you think about it. Watch the visuals. I think there's like 3 or 4 visuals for this EP already, so that's pretty dope. I think she just dropped one, so listen to that, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff, and let me know what you think about it. It is yours truly, Rick the Prince, and we out.